folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and this is going to be a lot of fun. Today I'm here to show you seven of the best intermediate guitars with Floyd Rose systems. First off, I just want to say I'm using the term Floyd Rose as an umbrella term for double locking tremolo. The title of this video should actually be seven best intermediate electric guitars with double locking tremolos, but that's far too wordy. Essentially, anything that double locks and is a lot of fun to play with. So Ibanez edges, Floyd Rose branded tremolos, and EVH licensed trems. And this is also the case for fully floating trems where you can pull the bar back and raise the pitch of the note up, and non-floating trems where all you can do is drop the bar, making it sound like this. Also, intermediate is a pretty broad term, so I'm kind of going monetary. There is going to be a best cheap guitars with Floyd Roses that don't suck video coming very soon, and maybe a nice expensive one if PMT will let me get my hands on some expensive guitars. So intermediate, I'm thinking 500 quid to £1,000. So not your starter guitar. A lot of people probably aren't going to buy a Floyd Rose equipped guitar as their starter guitar because they're a bit of a faff to mess on with. Second guitar, an intermediate guitar, when you're taking guitar a bit more seriously and you want to spend a bit more. So all the guitars in this video are going to be between £500 and £1,000. We've got offerings from Schecter, Fender, Kramer, Charvel, Ibanez, and Jackson. I'm also well aware there are far more than just seven best intermediate guitars with Floyd Rose systems that cost between £500 and £1,000. I just don't want to bore you by playing 25 guitars over the course of 3 hours doing loads of dive bombs. So with that, please comment down below your favorite guitar in that price point, some specs, why you love it, and why people should check them out. And with that as well, the prices of these guitars, I will link them all in the description box down below so you can check them out at pmtonline.co.uk. However, prices change all the time, inflation's a thing, so that's why I'm not going to mention any prices in this video. I'll be giving you a quick rundown of each guitar, some specs, what they sound like, and why they're so awesome. I'm running through two tech cables into a Daddario chromatic pedal tuner, into the amazing PV6505 mini head, Blackstar cab mic'd up with a Lewis MTP440 microphone. Right, if you're new here, I'm Dagan and I love Floyd Rose systems. 98% of my guitars have Floyd Rose systems on and I love them to bits. They're so much fun to play with. If you're not a fan, these aren't going anywhere. These will be around forever. They're one of the biggest innovations to ever happen to the guitar, and some people think they're a crutch and they sound ridiculous, but tell Eddie Van Halen that. Tell Steve Vai that. Tell Dimebag Darrell and Mick Mars that. They're amazing things, and these are the guitars you can get if you want to spend a little bit more, but not too much. Let's get started with the Schecter Sun Valley Super Shredder. What a name. So this is a Schecter Sun Valley Super Shredder. This is the one without the Sustainiac in the neck because that bumps up the price a little bit, and Sustainiacs aren't for everyone. The reason I think the Schecter Sun Valley Super Shredder is one of the best guitars for the price of the Floyd Rose is not only the specs, which I'll talk about shortly, but also the heritage. Schecter made its name back in the late 70s, early 80s by hot rodding Stratocaster style guitars, essentially. So you take your Stratocaster, or even get them to build a guitar from Strats from scratch before they were even a brand, take your guitar to Schecter and they will modify it. They will hot rod it. And hot rod Strats are the essence of Floyd Rose equipped guitars. It was the first ones around. So the heritage of this is one of the first essentially Floyd Rose hot rod guitars. But this is obviously modern. Schecter's modern take at what a hot rod guitar is for 2021. This was 2020, but 2021. Mahogany body, which is quite unique for a Strat. A lovely thin maple neck with a 14-inch radius rosewood fingerboard. So a lovely flat fingerboard, perfect for getting your Sun Valley shred on. 24 extra jumbo frets, so a full 2-octave range. And that lovely color-matched headstock. There are some funky colors on this guitar, so check them out at PMT. The pickups in this guitar are really cool as well. They have EMG retroactive pickups, which are EMG's latest variant of pickups. You normally see EMGs that are fully blacked out. You actually see the coils on these, and these are active pickups, but they're a bit more passive sounding, a bit more dynamic, and kind of less compressed and full on than, say, an EMG 81. There's a hot 70 in the bridge and a fat 55 in the neck. Neck pickup is like a modified PAF, like a hot wound PAF pickup, and the bridge is a good old-fashioned 80s rock and roll pickup. One volume for each pickup, no tone control, and a three-way toggle switch as opposed to the blade switches that you'll usually see. Now, it's weird not having a tone control, but it's totally fine. When you have the toggle in two volumes, you can do this. In and get your kill switch on. The Floyd Rose system on this guitar is a floating trem, so full on floating, you can dive bomb till your heart's content and go all the way to the sky. And these have Floyd Rose Hot Rod Special tremolos on them. So the whole guitar is a hot rod, but that's just the term. This tremolo is only made for Schecter by Floyd Rose. It's a Floyd Rose Special, but it's actually called a hot rod. It has stainless steel locking screws at the back and stainless steel intonation screws, also stainless steel locking screws up on the locking nut as well. So aesthetically, it's very pleasing, but that stainless steel gives it a bit more strength and durability. And it's just fantastic. It's a beautiful, smooth trem. And with that, it is a Floyd Rose Special. Some people turn their nose up some of the more budget-friendly Floyd Rose systems, like Floyd Rose Specials and Floyd Rose 1000s, when you're not spending hundreds or hundreds on an original Floyd Rose. Don't be one of those guys. Floyd Roses are great no matter what, and as long as your guitar is set up like Schecters are great from the factory, it's not going to go out of tune. It's going to stand the test of time. Just set your guitar up properly. They're all just great. So just, they're great, okay? You do get a lovely creaminess from that neck pickup, the Fat 55 EMG Retroactive. I'm not going to do full reviews on these guitars, just little sound bites and speak to you about how awesome they are. So the neck pickup has a beautiful creaminess to it, but it's got that hot rodded undertone. So dirty it sounds great, clean it sounds great. It's not the most versatile guitar in the world, but what it does absolutely spectacularly. Check out the back as well. There's a lovely access heel, so you can get to that 24th fret, the full 2 octave. I forgot I was on clean. No problem at all. It's super easy with that access heel. Yeah, this has been the Schecter Sun Valley Super Shredder, and it's a great Floyd Rose equipped guitar. Next up, we have this amazing guitar. This is the Ibanez Jiva Jr. And it absolutely rips. I had to use an Ibanez in this little rundown of best intermediate guitars with a Floyd Rose, or in this case, an Ibanez Edge 02 Tremolo. And there's RGs, there's S-Series, there's Procedures, there's Premiums. I thought I would use this Jiva Jr. This is the second signature guitar of Miss Nita Strauss, the amazing guitar player from Alice Cooper, Iron Maidens, and her own solo stuff. And one, it looks awesome. Two, it's in the price range I wanted to you have in this video. And three, it plays like an absolute dream. So this is Jiva Jr., Nita's second and more budget-friendly signature guitar. The first one, Jiva, came out a couple of years ago. It's kind of like a full fat version. This is a slightly more stripped back, but they do feature the same tremolo. This Edge Zero tremolo is just beautiful. It flutters like nothing else. To get your Nita Strauss on, or get your Steve Vai on, to get your Joe Satriani on, it's awesome. so it has the same trem as the full fat variant. The only real difference is the pickups. This has Ibanez Quantum pickups in, whereas the original has Neither's signature Damasio Pandemoniums. Maranti body, beautiful quilted maple top in, what's it called again? Deep Space Burst, I believe. One volume, one tone, and it's the S style. So it's super thin and super well balanced. That's why Neither likes these S series. Five-way switch for all the tonal options. Wizard 3 profile bolt-on maple neck. Ebony fingerboard with 24 jumbo frets and that beautiful heartbeat monitor that goes up to the 24th fret. Matching headstock, and it's just glorious. And the reason I like this guitar so much is because it features a HSH configuration. It might not have the signature Damasios in, but these Quantum pickups are absolutely awesome. There's two ceramic humbuckers in the neck and the bridge, and an Alnico single coil in the middle. And with a five-way switch means this is one of the most versatile, beautiful looking Ibanezes you will ever play. Let's hear some clean tones with position four, which is the inner coil of the neck humbucker and that middle Alnico single coil. Go from that to and the neck humbucker is so creamy with the distorted sound. Those are some specs and why I believe the Ibanez Jiva Jr. is one of the best guitars for the price. It looks amazing, the trem is absolutely fantastic, and it plays beautifully. This is a Kramer 84, and for those regulars on this channel will know that I adore this guitar. And I had to include it in this list because not only do I love it, I think it's utterly fantastic for the price, but also the history. There are other Kramers available in this price point, like my own personal Pacer over on the left here, that have two pickups and are a bit more versatile. However, I chose the 84 because this is one of the first ever guitars to ever be released with a Floyd Rose system. Back in the 80s, if you wanted a Floyd Rose new on a guitar, you could only get them on a Kramer. Kramer had the only licensing deal with Floyd Rose to do a new guitar from the factory. You could buy them aftermarket and get them fitted to a guitar, but every Floyd Rose from new was put on a Kramer, which is absolutely fantastic. And that is down to the man, the myth, the legend that is Mr. Edward Van Halen. In my humble opinion, the most amazing guitar player to ever walk the face of the earth. And this is essentially his 5150. The beautiful Kramer 5150 with a single pickup on the Floyd Rose system. This is a faithful reissue of that guitar called the 84, and it's awesome. Alder body, beautiful slim taper maple neck, 12-inch radius fingerboard, that amazing Kramer hockey stick headstock. It's got the toolkit on the back as well for the Floyd Rose, one Seymour Duncan JB Zebra pickup. The trussrod adjustment is down here, just next to that 22nd medium jumbo fret, and it features a Floyd Rose 1000 trem. And this is the first one I want to talk about which isn't floating. So floating on the, where is it? Schecter, so you could pull it up. It was floating on Jiva Jr, so you could pull it up as well. This already goes down exactly the same way as Ed's did back in the day and most Kramers. So you can really only do the 80s, Kickstart My Heart, all the Eddie Van Halen stuff with this guitar. You can't do any of the Dimebag Darrell squeals. It was actually Steve Vai, I believe, who first invented the fact, let's cut a route out and pull it up. So I think that was Steve Vai, but this is mostly Edward's doing. So I had to include this guitar because it is the OG of Floyd Rose equipped guitars. It's a Kramer body style too, so it's like a Stratocaster but slightly shrunken down, helping with kind of ergonomics. You can get to the higher fret a bit easier. It's a bit easier to get around because it's slightly smaller. And it is more versatile than it looks as well. There might only be one pickup, but when you pull out the volume control, the single volume control, it splits it into series and parallel to get more a sound more akin to a single coil. Check this out. So this is a clean sound on the PV6505 with the full Duncan JB humbucker. Bit more mid-range, it takes some of the warmth away and it gets spanky. Just stays in tune perfectly. It's that ultimate 80s rock guitar, the Kramer 84. Get a Kramer Pacer if you want that iconic brand name, but with a bit more versatility. But if you want to stick to the original, the 84 is the way to go. Or the Beretta if you want a maple body. This amazing thing is a Charvel Style 1 San Dimas. It's from their Pro Mod collection, and besides really enjoying my stupid Geordie fingerprints, it just looks a million bucks. This guitar is another one of the OGs, one of the original Super Strat guitars from back in the 80s, the same as the 84 and the same as various Jacksons, which I'll talk about more in a second. This thing is a Super Strat through and through. Two Seymour Duncan pickups, a JB and a 59, that classic combination, Alder body, and it's a full-size Strat body, whereas the Kramer was a slightly more shaved-down body, this is full-size. The chat with these is, it's called the Style 1 because it's a Strat shape, and back before Charvel were owned by Fender, which they are now, you couldn't call them Stratocasters and Telecasters, and they made Strats and Tellies, so they were known as Style 1 and Style 2. This is from the Pro Mod series, so they still affectionately call it Style 1 and Style 2, which is really cool. It's got bolt-on super slim neck, well not super slim, it's not like Ibanez slim, but it's a slim kind of shredder neck and a glorious compound radius ebony fingerboard. And it's a thick piece of ebony as well, that's great. The same as Schecter, Charvel started by hot-rodding guitars and modifying guitars and pushing the boundaries to where regular run-of-the-mill Fender Strats and Telecasters never really went to. They were putting compound radiuses on things, they were putting Floyd Rose tremolos on things before they decided to become their own company, Charvel, which was also Jackson. Watch my video on a history of Jackson guitars to find out what's going on with Charvel and Jackson. But anyways, this guitar is hot-rodded for the 21st century. There's reinforcements running down the neck, so there's reinforcement rods, so this is going nowhere. It's super stable in any condition. fingerboard edges are hand rolled, so it feels like an old friend as soon as you pick it up. It feels like you've played this guitar for years, also helped by the fact that it's a hand-rubbed oil neck. Someone's rubbed oil in the back of the neck by hand, and it just feels like a comfortable guitar. It feels like your guitar, even though it's brand new off the wall. Nothing's sticky, there's nothing claggy, it doesn't feel like it's been painted. It's just glorious under your hands. One volume, one tone, three-way switch, and a coil tap for the pickups to get some single coil goodness. Oh, and the Floyd is floating, so you can pull up to get those epic squeals. Let's hear it some more. It's just a gorgeous thing to play. There's not modern touches, like it hasn't got a sculpted heel or anything. It's a classic super shredder, what all the best riffs in the world are written on. And even noting Eddie again, Eddie Van Halen was a huge Charvel user as well. He famously got the body for the Frankenstrat from the offcuts of Charvel bodies. The Bumblebee neck was originally a Charvel neck, and I'm sure the body was as well. So there's prominence in this Floyd Rose equipped guitar. And there's a gorgeous 59 neck pickup. So this is based off a 1959 Les Paul, but it's in the neck of a Super Strat. Very versatile thing. That's why the Charvel's awesome. That's some specs, some history, and how amazing it sounds. Sorry for the fingerprints. This guitar is just amazing. This is an EVH 5150 series guitar. Now, this has been out for a number of years in a few different incarnations. This isn't the most recent, but it's my favorite. This is the variant with the toggle switch down here, as opposed to up here, and there's no kill switch. So this is more akin to the Ernie Ball Music Man Van Halen model from the 90s, and obviously, the Kramer 5150. Obviously, when the EVH brand come to replicate Eddie's iconic guitar from the 80s, which was a Kramer, that guitar, they can't replicate it fully. So Eddie and EVH did what they do best and innovate and develop that guitar into something that feels more modern, feels more finely tuned, highly strung in the best possible way, and it's an utter masterpiece. These 5150 series guitars pretty much play themselves, and they look great as well. There's so many different variants available out there, and they just absolutely sing at you. So it has got that slightly shrunken down Strat style body akin to that and the original 5150 Kramer from the 80s. Two pickups though, that's one of the big innovations, and like the Kramer, they're bolted directly to the body. So there's no springs, there's no screws keeping them in place, balancing. They're bolted directly to the body, helping this thing resonate like nothing else. The pickups themselves are EVH Wolfgang pickups, Alnico 2, I believe. Basswood body, and the Floyd again, it doesn't go up, it just goes down the same way it was back in the 80s. But this features a detuner. I'll talk about this more in a second. And the Floyd itself is designed for EVH solely by Floyd Rose. So it is a Floyd Rose, but it's branded EVH. The toggle switch is super convenient down there. One volume, one tone, and it's low friction on the volume pot. So it's a super quick and super linear 0 to 10 for when you want to play Cathedral and stuff. But it's a high friction EVH. These are EVH branded, by the way. It's high friction tone control. So it's quite hard to move the tone control, but that's deliberate because you don't want to like accidentally knock it whilst you're playing. It has the gorgeous Wolfgang asymmetrical neck, which was originally taken from Ed's Kramer, but after years of playing it. So it's totally asymmetrical. And it's just molded to Eddie Van Halen's hand, which is a really nice feeling neck. It's a beautiful neck, so he's worked on that neck hard. And it's totally oil hand rubbed, the same as that Charvel. It features a compound radius fingerboard with 22 medium jumbo frets, an EVH style hockey stick headstock, and there's cool little appointments. The fact that the Floyd Rose locking nut goes in from the back as opposed to the front, a nice little nod to Floyd Rose's from the 80s. And I think that's it, EVH branded tuners. Yeah, it's awesome, it's iconic, not a lot of money, and one of the best guitars you can get if you like this style and versatility intermediately for this price with a Floyd on it. So if you don't know what a detuner is, that's one of the big selling points of the EVH guitars. You can't buy them separately, but they come as standard on these guitars. So the detuner is a little invention that Ed made in the 90s, and you can't go from E standard to drop D on a locked Floyd Rose equipped guitar very easily. You have to get the toolkit out and undo the Allen keys and then tune it down and set it up. Or if you're really lucky, the fine tuning will go back enough, but that's rarely the case, and there's not a lot of tuning to be had when you set it up that way. So the detuner, simply pull it out and you're in drop D, push it back in. This guitar features a neck pickup too, which is quite rare for the EVH brand, and this style guitar that isn't a Wolfgang is just glorious because it's a beautiful creamy sounding Wolfgang neck pickup. Yeah. So there's a lot of bite in these pickups on a distorted tone, but it clears up beautifully, and that bite turns into clarity and mid-focused loveliness on a clean sound. Some history, some specs, sights and sounds on the amazing EVH 5150 series guitar. There is a full review and demo of this guitar at PMTVUK. I'll link it down below, be sure to check it out. This is one of my new favorite guitars of all time. You might have seen it in some other PMT videos and I can't put it down. This is a Jackson Rhoads model from the Pro Series. It's the RR3 and it's in that iconic Concord finish. I can't stop playing this guitar. It's absolutely amazing. There's loads of other Jacksons in this price point. If anything, this is a little bit more. I think this is £40 more than the budget, but look at it. If you want a pointy guitar with a Floyd Rose and that is your budget, there's nothing more iconic and nothing as pleasing to play and to look in a mirror and see yourself holding than a Rhoads model, especially in the Concord, which was the first variant of this guitar. This one is shaped differently though because Randy didn't like the original Concord, but this is the finish. The white with the pinstripes and the gold hardware, it's glorious. It's a neck-through construction, so it's a maple neck that follows all the way through the body with mahogany wings making this iconic Rhoads shape. And because it's a neck through, it just resonates like nothing else. It's a dodgy shape, I know, and it shouldn't feel and sound as good as it does to the purists out there, but it just rings and rings. So damn good. Two Seymour Duncan distortion pickups, one volume, one tone, and a three-way switch, and that beautiful golden Floyd Rose. Compound radius, ebony fingerboard with 22 jumbo frets and those iconic shark fin inlays, the beautiful Concord nose-esque Jackson headstock, and like I mentioned with the Charvel, if you want to find out how this guitar came about and how Charvel and Jackson is pretty much the same company, watch the video I mentioned earlier, 7 awesome facts you probably didn't know about Jackson guitars. But this is a thing to behold. When you play it, all you want to do is just... Harmonics just jump out as well. So when it comes to doing dive bombs and stuff, I don't think anything here dive bombs as well as this guitar. So that's the bridge pickup. It's lovely and gnarly. I'm trying to play all similar things on these guitars so you get a good idea of the differences, the different tonal properties, as well as the specs and stuff. That, and I'm not as good as Randy Rhoads, so. So you can be crazy like the dive bombs you heard before, or you can be subtle. This is a fully floating trem. unlike the EVH guitars and the just the EVH guitars, so you can pull up as well, which makes it lovely for clean. Traditionalist, but this guitar looks the coolest out of all of these by far. Just look at it, it's amazing. And last but certainly not least, we have this. Essentially the one that started it all. None of the guitars around me right now would be here if it wasn't for a guitar pretty much exactly like this. This is one of the new Fender Player Series Floyd Rose equipped HSS Strats. Essentially, this is a Fender Player Series Stratocaster modified, hot rodded, in-house by Fender. It's one of the Player Series, so it's extremely well renowned the world over for being amazing playing, feeling, and sounding. I've had people at PMT try American Strats and then try a Player Series and end up walking out with two Player Series as opposed to an American Strat. They feel that good, they are unbelievable, and now they're hot rodded. So, like I was saying with Schecter and Charvel and all that back in the day, they used to take guitars, standard Stratocasters, and throw Floyd Roses on them and throw humbuckers in the bridge. Why doesn't the OG do that themselves? This is modified by Fender to be a hot rod Strat, and it's just breathtaking. It's that classic vibe of new school and old school. You turn heads when you play something like this. And it's extremely versatile. It's a Strat, it's one of the most versatile guitars on the planet. The whole reason Strats are shaped like this is to be very comfortable sitting down, standing up, with a strap high, strap low. There's three pickups to be versatile. It's just a sight to behold. These are Player Series pickups, so you can only get them in the Player Series Stratocaster. Floyd Rose Special, one volume, two tones, and a five-way switch for some beautiful single coil goodness you'll hear in a second. Alder body, a beautiful modern C profile bolt on maple neck with a 9.5-inch radius, so it's a very Fender feeling neck, whereas the other ones with a flat compound radius, 16 inches in the case of the Jiva. You've got that iconic Strat headstock, and this year is a 75th anniversary, so there's 75 on the back of the headstock, which is very cool. This is in polar white with the black pickguard. It does come in some other colors, but as soon as you play a proper Strat with a Floyd Rose on, it's like, no wonder they did it. No wonder they did it. About the Player Series pickups are the fact that they are Strat pickups. They are stereotypically Strat single coils, well, in the neck and the middle anyways, but they're not old school sounding. You can play old school stuff on them, but they also sound great for modern stuff. It's a modern single coil mixed, cross-pollinated with an old school single coil. So they're lovely, bright and chimey, but they're not too noisy, they're not too hissy. They're just right. And that bridge humbucker just screamed. But you can literally go from that, because it's a Strat, thank you. Right. I think that's it, ladies and gentlemen. That's all my fingers can take. That's all the dive bombs the people around me in this store I'm in can take. Let me know down below in the comments which is your favorite Floyd Rose equipped guitar for intermediates. I know there's lots more, like I said at the start, but hopefully you've made it this long in the video, and let me know what you think down below in the comments. Some sights, specs, and sounds. And as always, feel free to add any or expand on anything I've said in the comments down below. For me, it's gotta be the Kramer. It's the OG. I know I'm very biased with Kramer, but it's just iconic. Floyd Roses wouldn't be a thing if it wasn't for this and that. But I prefer that because it's just my cup of tea, but everyone's different. Let me know what you think down below in the comments. And everything is linked, like I said, in the description box down below. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on any of the guitars I've spoken about here today, again, get your fine self to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and now TikTok. Get over there to check out pictures of these guitars, but with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.